An American hunter will soon have a controversial new trophy hanging on his wall after getting the go-ahead to bring home the carcass of a lion he killed in Africa. It's the first time a lion trophy has been approved for import into the U.S. since the animal was listed as a threatened species under the Endangered Species Act 3 years ago. CNN's Polo Sandoval has the story.
An Orlando man has the green light from the U.S. government to bring home his kill. Documents first obtained by the Center for Biological Diversity show the hunter was issued a permit to import the skull, skin, teeth, and claws of a lion he hunted in Tanzania. John Jackson III, who represents the permit holder, defends this kind of hunting as crucial for conservation efforts in Africa, a way to ensure a delicate balance in the survival of various species.
Most lion habitat is in hunting areas, and then the prey base is dependent upon that habitat. So the hunting operators are crucial. The lion, most of the lion that exists depend upon American hunters. We wouldn't have more than half our lions.
Jackson is also a member of a panel assembled by the Trump administration last year, tasked with advising on how trophy hunting helps conservation. He's also worked on rhino protection efforts for decades. Last week, another American hunter represented by Jackson faced backlash after being granted a permit to import a black rhino that he hunted in Namibia.
The primary threat to black rhino is poaching. And the revenue of these hunts goes 100% of it, nothing taken out, goes to a product trust fund run by the government. All that money is spent on rhino conservation, control the poaching.
In Namibia, where the vulnerable rhino population is grown, permits are issued to hunt pre-selected problematic bulls. Lions are fair game for other reasons.
The lion, its primary threat is loss of habitat and loss of prey base, and then conflict with community people, because a lion is really a ferocious beast, the greatest beast in the world. They're not compatible with people and livestock. So you have different problems and issues and different things that have to be shown to obtain a permit.
But the stringent requirements for trophy imports are not enough to calm concerns at the Center for Biological Diversity, where its legal director, Tanya Santarib, is worried these permits could someday lead to open season on other vulnerable species.
It signals an opening of the floodgates, not only for lion trophy imports from Tanzania, but also potentially for elephant trophy imports from Tanzania.
So-called conservation hunting continues to be a source of debate.
Trophy hunters love to say that they help contribute to anti-poaching efforts and that even just having hunters on the ground helps on that. But actually, the opposite has been demonstrated. Having people with guns legally on the ground provides great cover for people who are out there illegally to get ivory and other animal products.
The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service currently makes a call on trophy imports, saying the agency makes findings on an application-by-application basis. Polo Sandoval, CNN, New York.
Jeff Corwin is an expert in wildlife and host of ABC's Ocean Treks with Jeff Corwin. Jeff, thanks for being with us. First, your reaction to this decision by U.S. Fish and Wildlife to allow the lion trophy to come into the U.S.?
Good evening, Anna. It's a tragic decision. It's an awful decision. It shows how reckless they are with the environment. But it's a decision that, to me, unfortunately, is not surprising with this administration.
I mean, there is an argument to be made here that this does not harm conservation efforts. According to Fish and Wildlife, they argue legal, well-regulated hunting as part of a sound management program can benefit the conservation of certain species by providing incentives to local communities to conserve the species and by putting much-needed revenue back into conservation. What do you make of that argument?
You bring up an interesting point, Anna, and you know, in certain situations in the United States where people go get their tag for the white-tailed deer or spring turkey, that money gets put right into conservation. For example, 90% of the money used in New Hampshire to protect natural resources comes from ticket violations, hunting and fishing license, and public recreational land use. So that model might work in the United States, but it doesn't work in Africa. Out of the 54 countries in Africa, only 6 countries today allow hunting. Every year, it's less and less because it just doesn't work. They don't have the regulation. They don't have the law enforcement. And Anna, they don't have the checks and balances to ensure that people are following the rules.
Now, we know this is not the first decision like this. Just last week, we learned of another American hunter who was granted a permit to import a black rhino he had killed in Namibia as part of a hunting trip there. Do you see the floodgates opening?
Under this administration, I do. And it's borderline criminal to me. There's never, Anna, a logical reason. There's never a sound biological conservation reason to hunt endangered species. The black rhino population is hovering at around 5,000 animals. The lion population in Africa, less than a century ago, more than 200,000 animals. Today, less than 20,000. They are eclipsing into extinction, and hunting a healthy lion in no way contributes to saving that species. It just, the logic isn't sound there.
I'm sure this will not be the end of the great debate. Jeff Corwin, I do appreciate you taking the time with us, especially knowing that it's challenging when you're overseas, but we do think it's an important discussion to have, so glad you could join us.